Let's start from simple mechanical elements. Mechanical systems is consisted of translational, rotational or a combination of both components. And most of this kind of systems we will use Newton's law of motion. Translational motions, first of all. Translational motion can take place along a straight or curved path. The variables that are used to describe translational motion are acceleration, velocity, and displacement. You have already known it. What is the Newton's law? Newton's law of motion, algebraic sum of external forces acting on a rigid body in a given direction is equal to the product of mass of the body. So we can give this formula. As you see here, sum of the forces, which is external only, not internal, is equal to m times a. M means, as you know, mass of a rigid body. A is the acceleration in the direction which is considered. In figure 2.1, we have a force mass system. We have a force acting this system, which is represented with Ft, and direction or displacement represents with the yt, and according to this system Ft will be mat. At acceleration, as you know, if we talk about the displacement, we can represent the acceleration the second order differentiation, as you see here. But also you can also represent this formula by using the velocity m times differentiate velocity according to the t. Yes, yt is the displacement of the mass. As a general principle, we have to draw a free body diagram of the system if you get the exact mathematical model. How can we do it? For example, for this kind of system, we can get a Collant model as in B. This is a spring and damper and mass spring damper system. And free body diagram can be given as like that. Fs means act on this rigid body for only spring. Ft means for the damping effect. Okay, Ft is already external force. Let's continue from the linear spring. Linear spring model can be given in figure 2.3. We have a force in direction as like that. And K is the spring constant, or it can be said simply stiffness, as you hear. And it is a constant only. It is not important for us. So the spring effect on the mass system can be calculated by using this formula. Fs is equal to k times yt. Y is, as you know, displacement function. The other effect is the friction. Friction, whenever there is motion or tendency of motion between two physical elements, frictional forces exist. It can be classified as viscous friction, static friction, or Coulomb friction. But if you want to get linear model, we will use always viscous friction, and it is also named as viscous damping. In here we have a note. The frictional forces encountered in physical systems are usually of a nonlinear nature, unfortunately. What is the formula for this damping? Before this, we have a dashpot for viscous friction. It can be represented by this symbol, as you see, and Fd. Fd is equal to b times dyt over dt, the first derivative of the yt, where b is the viscous damping coefficient. So The overall system will be, this is the external forces, this one and this one internal forces, as you see here. So all forces can be given as like that, are equal to m times at, and at, as I said before, will be d square y t over dt square. Okay, for this system you apply a force as like that, but also for this system we have some internal forces such as spring effect and damping effect. Okay, we talked about now those ones. So the sum of the forces will be Ft minus Fs minus Fd, okay, are equal to m at, and at, as you know, m d square displacement yt over dt square. That's all. It's so easy. We can arrange these kind of formulas as like that. Yes, here we have 2.7 equation. We can arrange this formula as like that. Fd is a side of the equivalent. The other side, m d square yt dt square, it comes from mass, okay? And the other one comes from the friction or damping, of course, and the last one comes from the friction, damping, and mass. So mass damp friction system. If you arranged this formula as like that, it's mean the second order differentiate of the y, as you know. If you over by m all of these equivalent 2.8, you will get this formula. We know this rt and yt has the same units. Rt is input for this system and yt is output. Rt means actually force, external force, but y is displacement. Okay, we can also show this formula by using this notation. In this notation, Kc is the damping ratio, omega n is the natural frequency, and that's all. This is the prototype second order system. The second one is the rotational motion, as you see here. For the most applications encountered in modern control system, rotational motion of a body can be defined as motion about a fixed axis, not the others. We will talk about the fixed axis. And we will use Newton's second law for the rotational motions. What is this? The sum of moments, which is external ones, is equal to J times A. J means here inertia, and A means angular acceleration here. In here, J is the inertia, A is the angular acceleration. There is only difference between the first one. The other variables about us, torque, angular velocity, and angular displacement theta. Let's continue from the inertia. Inertia, a three-dimensional rigid body of mass m, has three moments of inertia and three products of inertia. It can be given by using this formula. J is equal to 1 over 2 m r square. R is the radius. Let's examine in this system. For this system, we apply a torque here, a moment, and for this system we have an inertia, which represents as J, and the displacement, angular displacement, represents as theta. According to this system, we can give this formula. GAT means J times the first derivative of the omega, and also is equal to J, the second derivative of the angular displacement. What is the affecting issue for this system? The first one is the torsional spring here. It can be often negligible, but we can learn easily. We have a constant torsional spring constant K, and the equivalent of this system can be given by this formula. TS is equal to K times theta T. According to the first system, you can be evaluate as spring. Actually, it is the same as you see here. This is the system, and the second one is the equivalent system, and the last one is the free body diagram. Never mind this formula. And the second one, viscous damping for rotational motion. For the viscous damping, we'll use this formula, B times the first derivative of the theta with respect to the T. B is, as you know, viscous damping. Finally, we can get this formula. This comes from the inertia. It comes from the viscous damping, and it comes from the torsional spring, as you see in this formula. So we can rearrange this formula by dividing J, as you see here, and RT again is the input or applied force, and it will be the same with the prototype second order system, as like that. Omega n again, natural frequency, and Qc is the damping ratio. That's all. Notice that this system is analogous to the translational system as given before.